Hello guys, we were discussing about gratuity. Now have a second question for you, okay? Because in one question we don't understand, I have selected one more question. We'll try to work out on the second question. So before starting the second question, the first question's answer, whatever we have written, I will rub it, okay? So that it becomes easy for you to understand. Because if these numbers are there, you may get confused, right? So therefore, what I am doing, I am just rubbing the numbers. So now let us see how to work on this question. Okay. I'll read out the question, guys. Mr. Anand, a resident, retired from XY Limited on 31st of December 2017. See, December 2017, what is our previous year? Our previous year is 2017-18. Means 1/4/17 to 31st March 18. During our previous year, he retired. Now, in this company, he has put in 33 years and 9 months of service. How many years? 33 years and 9 months of service. And his monthly salary at the time of retirement on 1/10/2013. That means from 2013, he was getting a salary of 12,000 rupees as a monthly amount of basic salary. And DRS allowance is 3,000 rupees and HRA rupees 2,000 rupees per month. Find out exempted amount. This is DA, we can take it as a per month, okay? And HRA also per month. Find out exempted amount of gratuity if he is covered under Gratuity Act, not covered under Gratuity Act. Very simple, guys. Everything is clearly given. What we need to do is we have to analyze the question. Now, we will work out on covered under Gratuity Act. See, when he is covered under Gratuity Act, what is the rules what we have learned in the earlier video? Covered under Gratuity Act of 1972, we have actual gratuity received. See, what is the actual amount of gratuity he received is 3,25,000. Let us write it here. 3,25,000. Next, what is to be required? Actually, he received 3,25,000. What is the maximum limit? 20 lakhs. Right? So, we have written whatever we know. Now, what is required for his salary loss run? See, his monthly salary at the time of retirement, 1/10/2013, if he is given any number, any year, we will take 12,000 only. Now, we will calculate what is the salary for the purpose of gratuity covered under. So, salary for the purpose is basic salary plus DA. See, we don't look at here whether the DA is enters into retirement benefit or not. Because it is not required, it is not mentioned here. We will take anyhow, DA should be taken. DA is a part of the salary at the time of retirement. Am I right? Now, what is the basic salary? Monthly salary is 12,000. Now, 12,000 into 12 is 1,44,000. I'm sorry. How much it is? 1,44,000. Next, DA. DA is how much? 3,000 per month. Into 12. How much we get? 36,000. What is the total amount? Is 10, 8, 1. That means 1,80,000 rupees. Or else you can do like this also. Instead of taking into 12, we will take directly 12,000 plus 3,000. Okay? Because we want salary loss drawn. So he was getting 12,000 rupees. Plus 3,000 rupees, he was getting 15,000 rupees per month as a salary. Now, 15,000 was the salary into 15/26 divided into how many number of years of service he did? He completed how many years? 33 years and 9 months. Here, 9 months is more than 6 months. In case of covered under Gratuity Act, if he worked for more than 6 months in fraction in months, it is considered as 1 year. Now 9 months is considered as 1 year. 1 plus 33 is 34 years. Now multiply 34 years here, so you will get 2,94,231 rupees. 2,94,231 rupees. Now just check with which is the least of this amount. Is it 3,25,000? Is it 20 lakhs? Is it 2,94,231? The least amount is 2,94,321. Am I right? Now let us deduct 2,94,231. Now what is the taxable? This is the amount of exemption. This is an exempted portion, and the balance amount taxable is 9,670. 12 minus 9 is 3, and 30,769. Now we have learnt this taxable amount of gratuity is 30,769. You just follow with the format. Actually, he is not asked what is the taxable amount of gratuity. He is asking find out the exempted amount of gratuity. You can write at the end like exempted amount of gratuity is 2,94,231. Okay. Now let us come to the second question. What is the second question is asked? If the employee is not covered under payment of gratuity act, right? What is the rules for the not covered under the payment of gratuity? Very simple. Actual gratuity received, least is exempted under section 10, subsection 10, actual gratuity. Now what is actual gratuity received is 3,25,000, and the first least amount is 3,25,000. And maximum limit is, we know that it is 20 lakhs. And third point is very important here. See, when we are taking third point, half month salary, that is 1 by 2 is nothing but half month salary of average salary of 10 months. Average salary of 10 months is not given. Assume that whatever the 12,000 rupees of salary is drawing till now and the last 10 months also, we will consider it as what is the salary for the purpose of not covered is basic salary is 12,000 plus DA. What type of DA we should consider here, whether it is enters into retirement benefit or not. Let us see a DA. He is given 3,000 per month, but does he given it is enters into retirement benefit? He is not given. When he is not given, definitely we should not take it here. In case if he is given, with it is enters into retirement benefit, or one more word is there, it is a part of the salary, then definitely we would have taken here. Since retirement benefit word is not given, we should not take DA. Did you find commission anywhere in the question? No commission also. You may ask, sir, what about this HRA? See, always just we should take salary, basic, DA, commission. Except these three things, we should ignore all other things. If he is given HRA, if he is given any other items like city compensatory allowance or any amount of, we should not take into consideration. We should take only these three items. In this, DA should enter into retirement benefit. He is not given, we have taken zero. Commission is not given, we have taken zero. Then what is the salary for the purpose of not covered under payment of gratuity act is only 12,000. Now we can take 12,000 is the salary, average salary of 10 months into 1 by 2 into how many number of years of service is given? 33 years and 9 months. I told you in the first problem, we should never ever take the fraction months. We should never ever take the fraction months. Please consider only completed year of service as 33 years. Now, if you take off of this is 6,000. 6,000 into 3 is 1,80,000 and 3 is 18,000. So, it comes to 1,98,000. How much? 1,98,000. Now, let us check with which is the least item of this. 325? Not at all. Is it 20 lakhs? It's too much. Then how much? 1,98,000. So the least of these three items is 1,98,000. It should be deducted from the actual gratuity received. Now you get 15 minus 8 is 7 and 11 minus 9 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. That means 1,27,000 rupees is taxable amount of gratuity. But you should write only the exemption portion. You can round off. 1,98,000 is the exempted. So again, I'm repeating, my dear guys, whenever the question is asked to calculate both, we should remember one thing. What are the differences between covered rules and not covered rules? That is Payment of Gratuity Act rules and not covered under Payment of Gratuity Act rules. Here, first two points are remain same. Only the third point, third limit will be changing. Third limit, what it says, salary loss drawn into 15 by 26 into number of years of service. What it says here, 1 by 2 into average salary of 10 months into number of years of service. Again, there is a points here. Here, when you take a salary loss drawn, on the date of retirement, whatever the salary is getting as basic salary and DA, we will take it. Whether DA enters into retirement benefit or not, we will take it. And here we take 15 by 26, here we take 1 by 2. And number of services, more than 6 months, here we consider it as a 1 year. More than 6 months also, we ignore it, we never take it, we take only completed year of service. So these are the very, very important points that you have to remember when you are working on gratuity or computation of gratuity. So I hope all of you understood. We will meet up in the next video, which will be very interesting. Thank you.